Hey guys, welcome back. Thank you so much for being here. So in today's video, I'm gonna be sharing my luxury makeup picks. These are products that always make it back somehow into my collection. Every time fall comes around, they come back into rotation and I am really excited for fall. I mean, I'm pretty sure you hear that from everyone, but truly you guys, fall is a beautiful season. Super exciting. This is your first time here. Hey, what's up? My name is Gigi. Thank you so much for clicking on my channel. I hope you stay, subscribe for more, click that red button below, and also come over to my Instagram because we do a lot of fun things over there that we can do in here. And without further ado, let's start. Alrighty friends, so fall is here, leather season is here, love it. I love these puffy shirts. They're super in and they're gonna be very very in for fall. And I mean, this one is leather, so it's like a win-win, right? I love to wear leather pants for fall, you know, high boots, this, everything. And can we talk about a good bumpy lip? So as I mentioned, I'm gonna be sharing pretty much things that I think I'm gonna be reaching for quite a bit during this fall season. These are staples in my collection and I am very excited to share. So let's start off with some good old foundation, and the one that I'm gonna be talking about today is this one by Tom Ford. It is their Traceless Matte Foundation. It is a soft matte foundation. It has a good medium buildable color. I love the finish of this foundation. You guys, I've done reviews on this guy and I think this is one of those foundations that is worth every single penny. It is a soft matte finish, which is like the new thing these days. I feel like a lot of foundations are claiming to be soft matte. I just posted a review on the new NARS soft matte, which I don't have the entire bottle. Go ahead and watch my video if you want to see my thoughts on that foundation. I only had a sample, but I already picked out the full size, so I'm giving it away already. These two are going to be staples. I already know that. I love a soft matte finish. It is a comfortable, really natural matte looking foundation. I think this foundation is just precious. I know I'm gonna run through this very, very quickly. During fall time, I don't really like a dewy foundation. I don't know, there's something about a matte base that I love, and then I'm gonna add my glow as I need to. So today I'm wearing this guy. Highly recommend if you want an alternative. Again, the NARS soft matte, you can go wrong with either of these two foundations. They're just a beautiful, really long lasting, and even though they're matte, they're very comfortable. So I love those two for fall. Next up, let's talk about a powder that is extremely special to me, dear to my heart, and it is my Kojendo Natural Lighting Powder. I love this powder, you guys. If you look at this powder real close, you're not gonna be able to see it. It has a tint, so it's not a white, you know, white kind of powder. I love these powders for my complexion because they're not gonna make you look, you know, like it's not stark white, is what I meant to say. But anyways, this is a beautiful natural looking powder. I love it for underneath my eyes. I love it for all over my face. It is stunning. But I did wanted to mention my Gucci. This is a matte natural powder, and you guys, the only problem is that it keeps getting hard pan every time that I use it. You know how you have leftovers on foundation brushes, and then you go in. This has happened to me twice, but then I take a little bit of tape and I just gently just pull the first layer of the powder and it gets resolved. This is such a beautiful and blurring and just natural powder. If you look at it really close up, it has a little specks of something something that is not gonna really look glittery or anything at all, you guys. It is stunning. It looks very natural. I love this powder. If you can get your hands on it, I highly recommend you do. This is tricky to find. I'm gonna make sure to link wherever I can find if you're in the States and if you're in Canada. But yeah, this is a beautiful powder that I feel like I'm going to be grabbing for a ton during fall time. When it comes to bronzer, I did use my Tom Ford Shade and Illuminate bronzer. This is a beautiful double compact. I don't really reach for the highlighter at all, but the bronzer here has a beautiful tone. I do use the shade Intensity 1, and look at this swatch. It is a very neutral, very contoury, so I love that chisel, you know, effect that this color specifically gives me. It is so easy to blend, very easy to apply. I use the brush, but you can use a dampened sponge, whatever you like, and it is just a beautiful product. So highly recommend this one by Tom Ford. So when it comes to bronzers, it depends on what I feel in. I have very different bronzers that I do want to mention today, but they are beautiful for different reasons. So the first one, actually the one that I'm wearing, is one by Gucci. It is their Eclat Soleil bronzer. I have the shade 3, and this is just a beautiful, beautiful bronzer. I'm going to do swatches so we can see the difference in the tones of these bronzers. So this is the Gucci one that I really like. It is, you know, like a golden kind of bronzer. But then Charlotte's bronzer, you can't go wrong. I have the shade 10, but I also have medium. So this is 10, which is more red, a little bit deeper, as you can see, but it is a beautiful formula of bronzer. I love bronzer. Let me grab my medium. So medium, I have only the pen because I switched that for the 10. And so this is what medium looks like. So you can see it's really light on my complexion, but it shows up because of summer. I caught some color to my complexion, so I picked up 10, but this is a beautiful neutral tone of bronzer. I love the shade medium, so that one I have here in the box. And then the next one that I recently discovered and I've been obsessed is this one by Chantecaille. This is the shade Goa. This is a more red tone. Well, there it looks neutral, but on my skin it pulls more red. You can see there are different tones of bronzers. They're just a beautiful, depending on the makeup that you apply for that day. It is a beautiful, beautiful bronzer. Now let's swatch this one in the newest Hourglass palette, which I'm going to talk about just for the sake of the video. If you're into, look at these bronzers, love. So this is Hourglass. Then you have Gucci, which they're a little bit similar. Then you have Charlotte 10, Charlotte Medium, and then a Goa by Chantecaille. Love me some bronzer. I needed to share my faves at the moment. So for my complexion, I did use the newest Hour palette in Sculpture. This is a beautiful palette, you guys. I've reviewed this, I'll link it above. But I did use this guy mixed with this one underneath my eyes. It really brings a lot of light back to my under eyes whenever they're looking dull. I love the brightening effect that this powder has. And then I went ahead and I used this mauve tone blush, which you really have to build up on my complexion. I had to go like 5 times to show up like this, but it is just beautiful. It doesn't pick up on texture. It looks very seamlessly and just perfected. These powders, oh my god, they're so blurring and perfect. I love this palette. Highly, highly recommend. So because I do like a matte base, I usually like a liquid highlighter, and the one that I want to recommend is this one by Chanel. It is their Le Beige in the shade Sunkissed. This is just a beautiful product. It is a little bit golden, a little bit neutral. I think it's gonna suit so many skin tones. Don't be afraid of the color. It is so easy to apply. I apply with my fingers when I'm in a rush, or I use a brush if I want to be a little bit fancy like today, but it just looks extremely natural and pretty. Look at this glow, like it is pretty much undetectable. This is all that I have on my highlighter. I didn't want to apply anything else so that you can see how natural and pretty it looks. This is a beautiful, beautiful product by Chanel. I can't get enough. I've talked about this so many times, but truly it is a very pretty and natural, and yeah,
Love
it. Alrighty guys, so let's move on to eyeshadow. And I do have quite a bit to show you, but it's going to depend on your personal preference. So I wanted to give you options and you're gonna make your pick. So pretty much today on my eyes, and you're gonna see a really quick, you know, tutorial of me using this one. This is Natasha Denona Bronze Palette. I pretty much use this all over my lid. I deepen out my lid with this one, and that's all I did, you guys. Two shades, that's my favorite kind of eye look, when you have a lot on your eyelid, you know, and then you just buff the rest all over your eyes and you're good to go. Same shade on my under eyes, and it is just everything. I love bronze palette. I think this is one of my favorite palettes from Natasha. I do have quite a bit from her, and this is stunning. And for the price, you can't go wrong. Don't be intimidated, but this is just full. Like, look at it. This red is everything I've used this one all over my lid, and it's just absolutely stunning. I love Bronze Palette by Natasha, but I do also love her Sunrise, which I almost use for my look today. I love these red and berry tones. I love, like, you cover these. This is very neutral, but like, you can go there, girl. So it is a beautiful, beautiful palette. So these two palettes are just beautiful. I just hold them really dearly close to my heart. But so now let's talk about Metropolis, because this is just an all good palette all year round. I love these for the holidays, those blue pop of color, these red. Everything in here is just stunning. I love Metropolis palette, and again, I almost used this for today's look, but then I went with Bronze, which I think it is my top one from her. She's also come up with her Glam palette, and this is a beautiful palette, you guys. I did make a full review on this palette, and I have reviews on every single palette from Natasha. I'll leave them below, but this is a beautiful palette. It's not everyone's cup of tea. It is, you know, really glam, you guys, and for fall and the holidays, it is a very beautiful. So it's going to again, it just depends on personal preference. I did wanted to point out those four palettes from Natasha because they're stunning. But now, if you're in the hunt for little palettes, because I've been loving little palettes, I want to mention two. First one, Chanel newest fall quad by them. This is in the shade Candu Provocation. I hope I didn't butcher that too much. This is beautiful. I have a full review on this guy. I love this brown here. It's everything. Love it. And then I want to mention Jungle. Jungle is a very special palette. This is new by Dior. They reformulated their quince, and this one is just beautiful. It is cool tone. It is pretty. I get a brown, a green here, which I love. I get a pink, which I love. This is a very versatile kind of palette. Love the formula, love this. Okay guys, and we're almost done, almost there now. We just have lip piece to go through. And first one I'm wearing on my lips, it is by Pat McGrath. It is in the shade Leatherette. Ooh, interesting, Leatherette, leather, yes. This is a beautiful, you know, I guess you can say it is a brown, it is a little bit red, very bumpy, very pretty. It is in her Lux Trans formula, which is my fave. I love this guy. I also wanted to recommend these guys by Shantikai. These are part of their fall collection. I do have two shades to share. This is Tamarind. These are called the Lip Bells. And they're those sheer lipsticks that you have to, you know, just build up a little bit, but so comfortable, beautiful, beautiful formula. This is Tamarind, and this is the other one that I have in the shade Acacia, which is a little bit more pink. Another lipstick that I love for this time of the year is this one by Chanel. This is one of their newest shades. This is in the shade Light Brown, yeah. So let's put it beside pads. So this one is one of those very long wearing lipsticks. You wear this under a mask and it doesn't botch. So it is a light brown, you know, it is a lighter version of this guy. Very pretty. I love this guy on me. It pulls a little bit cool tone and vampy, which I love for this time of the year. So I love these ones. Any shade that you buy from the Chanel Dude and the guys, you can go wrong. I already picked up two more. I'm obsessed with them. And then last but not least, because we do need a nude, I do want to recommend my obsession. My current obsession is this one by Gucci. It is in the shade Painted Veil, and it is their matte, you know, their matte formula. Oh my god, that is my perfect nude. I wear it almost every single day. Beautiful packaging by Gucci. And yeah, last but not least, you guys, I do want to mention a setting spray. This one by Glow Recipe. It is their watermelon, you know, mist. These I love all year round. I do use these almost every single day, I think. And if you want to lock in your makeup, you can't go wrong with Charlotte's newest setting spray. These two are my babies. I love them so much. So I just wanted to give them an honorable mention. Alrighty, friends, and I think that was it for today. I feel like I should mention more, and then like if I keep reaching for things, this video isn't going to end. So we're just gonna leave it at this. Let me know your faves in the comments. Thank you so much for your love and support, my friends. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe, and I'll catch you next time. Bye.